not see death, and he was not found because God had taken him. That's an amazing statement, isn't it? Wow! This verse just tells us that this guy, Enoch, never died, right? How many of you believe that the Bible is true? It's the inerrant, inspired, infallible word of God. If the book says that Enoch did not taste death, that means he's still alive today, all right? He was just translated to heaven with God. So who is the oldest person still around? Someone might say, well, it's that Chinese lady that we've all seen running around Facebook. She's about 132 years old. And no. She's still young, all right? By the way, if you feel like you're getting up in years, you are still young compared to Enoch, all right? He's the oldest guy alive. And if you trace history back to Adam, that's approximately 6,000 years ago. Enoch was born when Adam was 622 years old. By the way, they lived a long time back then. That makes Enoch approximately 5,400 years old, minus a decade or two, all right? That's incredible. Some of you are thinking, Pastor Bob, that's absolutely impossible. Listen, nothing is impossible with God. There are two men who have lived an extraordinary long time. One is Enoch and the other is Elijah. Enoch was taken up by God and Elijah was taken up in a chariot and horses of fire in a whirlwind. And I believe that they're going to come back, and it could be very, very soon. They're going to come back, walk on the streets of Jerusalem as the two witnesses found in the book of Revelation. And that's a whole other story. I thought I'd just throw that in there. And so we have to ask ourselves the question, why did God take him? Well, let's go on to see what the Word says, all right? Hebrews 11, verse 5 and 6 says this, "For before Enoch was taken, he had this testimony, that he pleased God." Man, I hope that the testimony that the Lord has of me as I'm passing from this world is that Bob pleased God, right? And the scripture goes on, and I believe that the author, well, this is a very powerful verse in and of itself. I believe that the author of scripture was referring to Enoch because he uses some of those same words. He says, "Without faith, it's impossible to please him, for he who comes to God must believe that he is and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him." Enoch pleased God. He obviously was a person of faith. He believed that God existed. He believed in the incredible goodness of God, that if a person sought God, that God would reward him. And so he diligently sought after God, and God was pleased him, so pleased with him that he snatched him off the face of the earth. So let's jump in a little deeper into Enoch's life and figure out who this guy is. And let's ask the question, what were the origins of Enoch's faith? Now, we don't know much about Enoch. There's just a few places in the Bible. In Hebrews, we just read that part. In the book of Jude, we're going to read that in a while. And here in Genesis chapter 5. Let me read some verses out of Genesis. It says this, "Enoch lived 65 years and begot Methuselah. After he begot Methuselah, Enoch walked with God 300 years and had sons and daughters. So all the days of Enoch were 365 years, and Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him." Now, I want to talk to you a moment about that age that Enoch lived in. It's called the Antediluvian Age. It was the time before the flood. First of all, men and women lived a long time during those days. Enoch was the seventh generation from Adam and Eve, but already the world had become a very evil place. And because they had many, many children during those days, the population had already grown exponentially, all right? The Antediluvian Age was when there was a constant cloud cover. God watered the earth with dew and not with rain. I got up this morning, and on my way to church, I thought I was living in the Antediluvian Age, for any of y'all who were up as early as me, all right, with all that heavy fog and dew, all right? But we know that the people began began to get wicked very quickly. Last week we saw that Cain, right, rose up in the very first family and murdered his brother. From there, it was kind of a downward spiral. Interestingly enough, Genesis chapter 6 tells us that the sons of God, as the writer of Genesis said, I believe it was fallen angels that came down and had children with the daughters of men. And the scripture begins to describe the world during that season of time when men began to multiply on the face of the earth. Let me read to you Genesis 6 and verse number 5. It says this: Then the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every intent of the thought of his heart was only evil continually. Wow. This was a world that was so bad, so wicked, that God ultimately destroyed that entire world that he had made, except for, of course, those who were in the ark. Now, how many of you realize that mankind didn't get that way overnight, right? It just wasn't all of a sudden one day everybody was wicked. Just like people seem to get more, those who are inclined to do so, seem to get more wicked generation by generation as we live, even so it was in Enoch's day all the way to Noah's day. But as we read the word, the scripture tells us that Enoch lived 365 years, all right? So it also tells us that he walked with God for how long? 300 years. So we can only presume that in those first 65 years before he had Methuselah. That's a good Bible name. I don't know why anybody doesn't name their children Methuselah anymore. Can't you see a mom looking at that just looks like Methuselah. But anyway, before he had Methuselah, for those 65 years, I don't think that he walked with God. Otherwise, the scripture would have said he walked with God for 365 years. So there was something that happened in this man's life around the time of the birth of his son. Now, we don't know what caused him to turn to God. We don't have his testimony. We have very little biblical evidence about that. But I believe that it must have been a godly fear that got a hold of him. I believe that he saw the sinfulness of the world that he lived in, and he began to consider it. And I want you to think about this for a moment. Maybe it was a conversation with Adam, right? I know it may sound strange, but Adam would have been 687 years of age when Methuselah was born. Adam lived to 930 years of age. And perhaps it was Adam that told Enoch, man, I wish I was still walking with God in the garden in the cool of the day. Adam told him perhaps all of the things that had happened in the garden. And so just seven generations from Adam, it's not hard for us to believe that they still talked about the Garden of Eden, right? They understood the consequences of sin and how Adam and Eve had to be kicked out of the garden. And perhaps Adam and Eve had talked about the glory of being with God, of walking with God, and maybe perhaps even the place where the angel stood with the flaming sword guarding the way into the Garden of Eden. Maybe that was even known. But the scripture tells us that it was during this period of time that some men began to call upon the name of the Lord. Amen. The scripture says this, Genesis 4:26, then men began to call upon the name of the Lord. And Enoch was no doubt one of those men. And how many of you know this, that when you call upon his name, he's going to answer? Amen. When you seek after him with all of your heart, you're going to find him. When you go looking for him, he will make himself known to you. You will find him. He will reveal himself. And so this man by the name of Enoch began to seek after God because he wanted to know God. And here is also an interesting fact that we know, that by the time Methuselah was born, Enoch being 65 years old, he had already received, at least in some part, a divine revelation of what was to come. A couple of years ago in my personal devotions, I began to intensely study the book of Genesis. and I came across this, and I've always wanted to preach it, and now's my opportunity. But the scripture tells us that Methuselah, actually the word Methuselah literally means, are you with me? When he is dead, it shall come. When Methuselah is dead, it will come. In other words, God revealed to Enoch that there was a judgment coming, and that when Methuselah had died, it would finally come. All right? Now, that judgment was a long time in coming, because if you know your Bible trivia, Methuselah was the oldest man that had ever lived. I mean, as far as, you know, those who lived and died in the Bible. Methuselah lived 969 years, and you can actually take that out and reference in all of that, and you'll discover that when Methuselah died, that's when the flood came. Now Enoch may not have known that judgment was coming in the form of a flood. He might not have known that Noah would build an ark, but he had enough fear of God to begin walking with God, naming his son, when he is dead, it will come. You say, well, Pastor Bob, that was a long time to wait for judgment to come. 969 years. Let me tell you what that shows. It only shows us one thing. That, you know, I've often wondered, why did Methuselah live so long? It's because God is so wonderful. God is so long-suffering. God is so full of mercy. God is so full of care. He wanted men to have a place, a chance to get right with him before he destroyed the world. And I'll tell you, that divine revelation of judgment to come must have worked a powerful work in his life, because for the next 300 years, the scripture says that Enoch walked with God, and his walk of faith so pleased the Lord that the Lord took him. I know you're thinking, well, Pastor, what does this have to do with me? All right, here it is. Listen today. If Enoch can walk with God in his generation, when men's hearts were continually evil, amen, and Enoch not having the full, complete Word of God, come on, somebody, not having the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, not having a church to attend, not having lots of other believers to encourage him, not having teachers to show the way, and not having the understanding of history and all that is happening, and having all the examples of faith. Listen, church, what excuse do we have? Come on. I wonder, is there anybody in the house today that says, as for me and my house, we're going to walk with the Lord. We're going to go on with him. Amen. For the rest of our life. Hallelujah. And the question becomes, have you made that decision in your life? Have you determined, I'm going to walk with the Lord? And Enoch, around 65, completely repented of his sin and began to walk with God. He said to himself, you know, God exists, and if he exists, he must be good. And I'm going to seek him, and I'm going to diligently go after him. So here's the key, my friend. Don't wait until you're 65. Amen? Get right today. Amen. Some people say, well, I'm going to wait until I have children. As for right now, I'm just going to kind of enjoy the pleasures of youth. Listen, don't do that either, my friend. Get right today, because the Bible says that today is the day of salvation. Amen. And so the first thing the life of Enoch shows us, that it is faith, it is easy. I mean, it is possible to walk with God. Amen. Until that day, amen, when we meet him face to face. Hallelujah. So today, decide for Jesus. So what can we learn from Enoch's faith? First of all, we can learn that we can walk as Enoch walked with God.